so I can see the mix of the waves and the angle, even though I have my own mirror. What I really want is the word backwards. We preach. There's about 8 times that we preach and proclaim. We talk about how can we increase. That's by the second. That's the name of the great. We are going to take that out as we want to go through the week because they have faith for every single and the same of every one of you all to what we call it from here. So, we also talk about Proverbs being 5 through 12, and I trust in the Lord and me. And I need to say that. But you know, we want to make sure that as we walk by faith, we might allow situations and circumstances to cover how we respond and change. Because when things come up, it's easy when you hear a report and you see something and it's just casual and it's not good and you think it's wrong. And you will respond to it. But you know, you have to check in the spirit to not do anything. You have to be more sensitive to that inward witness, that still small voice on the inside of you. You know, that loud brain. And you know, many times, but most times, that's going to be the problem. Okay? He's trying to get you off course, he's trying to get you respond quickly, he's trying to get you respond in the text. And it's that still small voice, it's that proud voice on the inside of you that reels you in. And you have to be sensitive to you. Let this be the proud voice. It takes text, many times with the Lord. And you're able to hear for that, listen for that still small voice to give you the direction that you need. Amen. And so as we walk by faith, we want to follow through and hear from you. Amen. And example, amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And also, in our walk of faith, we are also reminded that you must say some things. You know, this is not a unspoken word. You've got to speak your faith. Amen. You've got to say what you believe. You've got to call things into existence. Because as the kind of Father called everything that went into existence, we also must call things into existence. You know, especially when it's contrary, you know, things are being still there and outside there. You know, you've got to be in that room. You look at your life and it's contrary to what you have in your life. Amen. You've got to start speaking something. Amen. You've got to start calling something to be that in your room. Amen. Because that's the way you bring things from the unseen to the seen. That's speaking those things out of faith. Amen. Allowing your words to what God's word says. Amen. It says in 1 John 5 and 14, it says, and this is the confidence that we have in Him, that we ask anything according to His will. So there's the qualifier, according to the word of God. That we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And whatsoever we ask, we have the petition that we desire of Him. And let's see here. Let's just turn there. Because that's really, really good. That's what we're going to do. Thank you, Isaiah 14 and 15. This is a confidence that we have in here that we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know He hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we hear the petition that we desire of Him. Also, let's go quickly here. John 13 and 7. Jesus is talking. He says, "Well, man, this is real love. This is real love. This is real love. He said, you abide in me, and my word abide in you. And he said, ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you." Amen. So when you are faced with the affairs of life, frustration that things are coming upon you, and you just got something about, you know, what you need to be doing. This is what you need to be doing. You need to be speaking about. You need to be proclaiming those things that you are believing for, and not the circumstance. Amen.
unless the circumstances were true.
such a great way to lose a guy just after you get home. And you don't get that kind of thing that you don't want to use. You get this special. Thank you. Yeah.
I'm going to get the question.
Thank you. is a guy who spoke to all of Christians, but there is a good of things disagreeing with others.
Well, you know, you didn't have to do it in the last time. I mean, you know, there's such a lot of things that we
do in our lives. Without understanding the covenant record, without nature, affection, and principle, all merciful, knowing the judgment of God, that God which commits such things already is but good. Not only will do the same, but have pleasure in the living. So, you know, what is it like to do? That's why, you know, I always wax, associates with you. You know, because if somebody says, you know, if I noticed it, or something in the big room, might be on the center, I'll take control of it. You know? Trying to see your color, but it might be the rest of you to your head anyway.
Thank you.
this in a minute. Up there, we look like a real amount of awareness. So this is all kind of thoughts and ideas, suggestions out there in the world, trying to put you back out of the darkness, you know? And so, when that is trying to keep into the church, you know, and so why are a lot of churches are so well done with this, you know, the right, you know, concentrated world, it's more about a couple, a social club. It's all about being seen in the big church. It's all about singing in the big group. It's all about being a member of the big festival. You know? Well, it's really all more about Jesus and the crucified. It's about this next story all more about, you know, what's more than the last story of the ghost.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Let's do it right.